Video from South Texas shows children literally being dropped over the border barrier. The number of children and their families seeking asylum are pushing resources in the state past their limits. Our Border Report team found that some of the children are now being flown to facilities in California as the federal government works to find ways to handle their asylum cases. Senator John Cornyn says he's working in Washington on bipartisan legislation to address the crisis. He wants to create a system where judges could hear the children's cases quickly while they are detained in an immigration facility. Cornyn says he's also concerned about the role of cartels in the migrant surge.
This is a very sophisticated criminal organization that is running people and drugs across the United States, across the border into the United States. For example, one reason they are flooding it with so many children is because they know the Border Patrol will have to come off the front line. Meanwhile, the drug cartels run drugs, methamphetamine, heroin, fentanyl, and the like into the United States through those openings. And frankly, this is all about money for them.
Governor Greg Abbott called on the president to designate Mexican drug cartels as foreign terrorists. The governor made the request in a letter to the president and vice president. The designation could give the government ability to enhance legal pressure on the criminal groups. We're learning more about the methods cartels use as they move migrants into South Texas, too. Our Border Report team learned that cartels are using different colored wristbands to mark the people they're smuggling across the border. We got video of the wristbands from migrants apprehended by Border Patrol agents in La Jolla, Texas. Red indicates first-time crossers. Purple means they can't try anymore. Most get three tries for the money they pay coyotes or human traffickers to cross the Rio Grande. Our Sandra Sanchez broke this story. You can see more of her reporting now at borderreport.com.
Legislation to let Texans carry guns without a permit is moving forward, but there's a powerful effort to stop the bill with backing from some unexpected allies at the Capitol. 2 years ago, our investigation caught the attention of state lawmakers.
We had inconsistent data in Texas. The collection process was not the same.
Now maternal health is taking priority at the Capitol, the legislation that could save mothers' lives.